All right, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is the End Time Truth Television channel. We urge you to subscribe to the channel, activate the bell icon by selecting all so that the next time we upload a new video, you will be among the first persons to be notified by Google. I'll be seeing you in the next video. Till then, shalom.
There has been a fire outbreak in the synagogue church of all nations. Lagos, Nigeria. The report has it that there was a fire outbreak at the Synagogue Church of All Nations located in the Ekoto area of Lagos State on Monday night. The Punch newspaper gathered that the fire, which got to the storehouse in the church's premises, started around 11 p.m. The fire incident happened on the night of the candle procession in honor of the late founder of the church, Prophet Temidokwe Joshua, popularly called TB Joshua. Members of the church who had attended the night of tributes and candlelight procession in his honor were seen scampering to safety during the fire incident. It was learned that the firefighters arrived at the scene of the fire incident around 12:19 a.m. on Tuesday. An eyewitness, however, said the fire had been put out before the arrival of the service. An electrical spark at the control room caused the fire. It happened after the candlelight procession, he added. The church confirmed the fire incident in a press statement, saying there was no casualty. The statement read, in the late evening of Monday, 5th July 2021, there was a minor electrical fire incident at a storehouse within the Synagogue Church of All Nations complex. The incident was quickly brought under control without any injuries. As part of the preparedness for the week-long services celebrating the life and legacy of Prophet TB Joshua, the Skowan has worked closely with relevant government agencies, including the Lagos State Fire Services, whose members were on the ground at the time of the incident. We thank God for his continued protection. We assure the general public that there is no cause for alarm, and the services celebrating the life and legacy of Prophet TB Joshua will continue as scheduled. The pastor, televangelist, philanthropist, leader, and founder of the Synagogue Church of All Nations died on June 5 at the age of 57. His widow, Evelyn Joshua, led the candlelight procession at the Skowan Faith Resort in the Ekotun area of Lagos. Remember that Skowan had announced that TB Joshua would be laid to rest on Friday, July 9th at the church premises in Lagos. The Lagos State government had inspected facilities at the Synagogue Church of All Nations for COVID safety and prevention protocols compliance in preparation for the funeral of its late founder, Prophet Temitokwe Joshua. The delegation from the Lagos State government was led by the Commissioner of Health, Professor Akin Abayomi, and the Director General of the Lagos State Safety Commission, Landre Mojola. Speaking after the inspection of the church facilities and meeting with the church officials, Abayomi said the inspection was in line with the third wave mitigation strategy of the Lagos State government to prevent the importation and spread of new deadly strains of COVID into Lagos and Nigeria. Abayomi added that the inspection and meeting with officials of Skowan were to limit any possibilities of the introduction of foreign COVID variants among the congregation by extension to the community, while noting that there are some areas of infection prevention protocols that needed strengthening in the church. Abayomi assured that those areas would be strengthened before and during the funeral activities. The team inspected the auditorium, marquee tent, hostel accommodation for international guests, and sanitary facilities. Beginning to wonder if these foreign guests are necessary at this point in time that the world is battling with this COVID of a thing. That's my thought anyway, before some thoughtless followers and defenders of the church and their prophet. I've even said somebody who had read somebody who read that TB Joshua was her God, you know. Before I'll be eating raw, Let's depend on our God who has been keeping us safe from COVID to do the rest. But for me, if you ask me, I do not think that exposing the whole nation to this, the risk of COVID at this time, is a necessity. But God has been faithful. So thank you. That is just the report. That is just the report. That's the report. Just intimating you of the incident that took place yesterday night. It was said to be after the candlelight procession, which I actually joined to bring part of it to those that watched. Well, thank you very much for watching. God bless you. I'll be seeing you in the next video. Till then, shalom.